breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Good evening. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Nigel Robertson in for Michael tonight. We begin with educators' concern over a proposed funding change that could be detrimental to school districts.
News 4's Parul Joshi is live and local in Anderson County. Parul?
Councilwoman Cindy Wilson wants to change the way money is distributed when corporations come to Anderson County. So today, council members and representatives from all five districts met to discuss it at the Anderson County Museum. When corporations promise a certain number of jobs, they can pay an annual fee instead of local property taxes. And after expenses are paid off the top from the agreement, most of the money goes to school districts. About 15% goes to the county, according to county officials. But under this new proposal, Wilson and other council members want to increase how much the county gets to support an aging sewer system that is operating in the red, which they say is vital for economic development. According to the Anderson County Board of Education, districts received more than $3 million last year from corporation fees. Board officials say that money goes to pay for things like teacher salaries, supplies, and training, and they worry what they would do if they lost it.
The only way we can save money is cut programs or cut people. About 90% of our budget is people.
And under this proposal, current deals will stay the same, but would affect the way money is distributed in future agreements for a period of time. Now, nothing's been finalized yet. A committee made up of council members and representatives from the districts will continue to discuss this issue in the coming weeks. Parul Joshi, WYFF News 4, live in Anderson County.
Parul, thank you. Spartanburg County deputies say they've arrested a mother for abandoning her teenage children. Susan Jordan is charged with child neglect. Deputies say her 17-year-old daughter went to them in March, saying she and her older brother hadn't seen their mother since February. According to a report, the children reported that they stayed in the family house until the power got turned off. Deputies say it's unclear where Jordan was all that time, but they recently found her in a jail in Saluda for a different crime. They were able to transfer her to Spartanburg County yesterday. A toddler died this week. He was found floating in a swimming pool. We're told the child was visiting a home on Canyon Lane in Pickens County. Officials were called to the home Wednesday evening. The coroner says 15-month-old Tylan Gosnell died on the way to Greenville Memorial Hospital. His death was ruled as an accidental drowning.
A pickup that was overheating caught fire on the interstate this morning. This all happened at exit 27 on I-85. The driver pulled over when the overheating started. He caught a ride to work. We're told someone saw smoke coming from under the hood, told the driver, who came back to find his car covered in flames. Firefighters put the flames out. Highway Patrol is investigating.
You are about to get a rare look inside part of GSP's evidence room, where firearms are filling up space at a rapid rate. Here's News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski with the airport's message to pack some common sense.
More than 100 rounds of ammunition, guns, and magazines.
They range anywhere from 22 caliber, 22 Magnum, 380, 32, 9mm, and 40 caliber here on the table.
They are sealed in plastic bags inside GSP Airport's evidence room. The items were all seized at the airport security checkpoint when people packed something they shouldn't.
99.9% of the people who come to the checkpoint with a firearm in their bag are completely unaware that that firearm is actually in the bag until they're told to step to the side by TSA.
In all of 2012, 9 firearms were detected here at the security checkpoint. So far this year, there have already been 12 incidents.
It could simply be chalked up in one word, careless.
Airport spokeswoman Rosalyn Weston says it's an expensive mistake, which starts with an automatic $473 fine and could go up after civil penalties. The detection of even a single bullet will lead to questioning by police and TSA. Plus, you'll probably miss your flight. Bottom line?
Even before you pack that bag, check that bag, know what's in your bag before you pack.
Gabrielle Komorowski, WYFF News 4, Spartanburg County.
GSP police tell us the guns are eventually given back to their owners after the case goes through the courts or they are destroyed.
National Weather Service survey crews said EF1 tornadoes touched down in Cherokee and Cobb counties in Georgia last night. There was at least one tornado with winds of up to 105 miles an hour. The damage included a Chevron gas station that had a portion of its roof peeled away and a gas pump blown over. Hundreds of trees were snapped or uprooted. A second tornado touched down about a half mile south of Woodstock in Cobb County. The storms caused widespread power outages across North Carolina. Heavy rains, hail, and strong winds uprooting trees knocked out power to several cities. At one point, Duke Energy was dealing with more than 200,000 outages in the Carolinas. It's still working on getting power back to tens of thousands of customers tonight. Virginia saw more of the same: strong winds, power outages. A Blacksburg man says he was surprised to see a tree split his home. And the wind toppled a mobile home near the Virginia coast. Power crews have been working today from the mountains to the coast to repair all the down lines. Chief Meteorologist John Cesarich joins us now. And John, how bad were the storms here?
Well, it really depends on where you live, Carol. But obviously, we had a solid line of, pretty much a broken line of very intense thunderstorms that moved across the area. Very electrical thunderstorms. Had over 2,000 to 3,000 hits of lightning just throughout the western Carolinas and northeastern Georgia yesterday afternoon through the evening. As you can see, look at all these lightning strikes. And in certain areas, we had some wind damage. We also had some isolated reports of some small hail. But overall, not too bad. The worst part of these thunderstorms actually were in the North Georgia mountains down through Atlanta and also in through the Charlotte area. So things are going to be fairly quiet tonight, but what about the rest of the holiday weekend? I'll have an answer for you a little bit later on.